Welcome to the Narrowboat that James built. Hope you're well. Thanks for joining us as we carry on leg one of our big trip to London.
Oh, right. We're off. Well, I spoke to the guy at Tesco's this morning at about 6:30 and he didn't seem to care that we were there overnight. He said there's always people here overnight. We have bought some stuff from them, so we're customers, that's all right. Now we just got to move two locks. So we're going to, I think it's Stocker's Farm is the one we're going to. Basically, that's going to be our staging point because we can get a car there. You okay, Ivy? You can come up and... All right. So this is Stocker's Lock, number 82. And this is just amazing, this place. I know Rickmansworth so well. And this is just so remote. Apart from the lock cottage and a few footpaths, there's no other way of getting here. Fantastic. As a result, the guy in that cottage up there gave us two windlasses. So we have replenished our stock. Right, one more lock to go. Coming up very soon is a disused industrial unit with a big gorilla, like toy gorilla, hanging from one of the gantries over the canal. Should be interesting to see. Approaching the lock, so I'm hoping there'll be somewhere more either above it or below it. Right, this guy's left the gates open, so I think I'm going to go straight in. Unless there's decent moorings after this boat here. But no, that looks like locked landing, and Rob and I are both not going to get on there, so we're going to have to carry on. Yeah? Okay, I'm going to get your drink in a minute. We're stopping now. I'm just going into a lock now, Ivy. Okay, here we are, lock 83, Springwell, bottom end of Rickmansworth. This was our target spot for the staging point because there's a canal side car park just there. But there's no moorings above the lock, so we're going to see if there's something underneath it.
Perfect. Looks to be enough room for Rob and I just down there. Oh, that couldn't be any better. Didn't want it to be far from that car park. Oh, I reckon we can just squeeze into that gap. We need 100 foot. Well, let's see what happens.
I'm moored up. This is going to be tight, but I reckon our South African sailor can make that happen. 75 foot gap to home a 70 foot boat. See what he does. There is a Y beam ahead of me with someone on board, so if I need to, I could possibly ask them to budge forward a sec.
I told you I could engineer a foot.
Very good, well done, mate. That is a clever idea. Well, we got in. Amazing. Yeah, I like that. It is good. Yeah. Well, there's a Brazil on it.
Yeah, I know. It might be about 17 years old, but.
So just after we moored up and we got all the boats just squeezed in, the guy in front of me left. So now we can unpin, space things out a little bit. I can get out from underneath this tree and put myself there-ish. So I've now moved up a little bit and now opposite this place. Never seen this before. But they are certainly embracing their canal side location. This is going to be fun mooring opposite this place. Got a good spot here underneath a conker tree. Nice little wide verge. Not much by way of stingers. And Rob's on a bit of a shelf, but his boat sits a lot lower in the water than mine. And he's fully laden with diesel, water and other things in other tanks. Tell Rob to turn his nav lights off.
But for that scramble for Germany earlier in the first half, seems about a week ago. That
happened. Come on, England.
It is hemp and it is deep.
Yes! Oh man, you were right. There is a 2 minute delay on iPlayer. Oh yes! Bristicle! So you don't get that in the boys' game.
But hang on. For anybody trying to light a fire using highly inflammable liquid, do not pour the bottle, use a little capful, and throw.
Nice. Good consumer advice there, Rob.
That's only because I've singed my eyebrows.
Right, we're having a barbecue on the top. What are we having for dinner?
We're having Burvors rolls.
Burvors rolls. This is such an idyllic setting. This is the quietest that we've known the canal. You can't hear any road noise here. There's no one worth... No trains. Yeah, it's the no trains. That's the main thing. But there's no road noise. There's no people walking up and down the towpath. This is just absolutely idyllic. And to think we're, I was just saying to Rob,
a little bit further up there is a footpath, which that is the boundary between Hertfordshire, which is kind of over there, and Hillingdon, which is here. And this is the London Borough of Hillingdon. So technically, we are in a London postal district. We're not going to class this as central London at all. But to think we're in London, and it is just dead. It is just peaceful as you like. We were saying it's quieter than cow roast. This is brilliant. Right, so one of the things that, well, Rob's just done it on his boat. He's just redone his trunking around there for his headlight and horn. And it's made me think about my horn for the boat. And obviously I haven't got one on there yet. I should have one. It reminded me when I did that really sharp right-hand bend going into Casterbury that a horn would be a good idea. But in London, as we're about to go through, there's a few sharp bends and there's a tunnel, so I think it's best to have it. The issues I've got horn-wise is where to mount it. If I mount it at the front, I've got to run the cable all the way back. I was just going to use an air horn, which basically would be obviously used by my own hand, which would be at the stern. So in terms of distance to where any collision could be, it's not going to make that much difference if the horn sound comes from there or comes from 40 foot behind it. It still should be loud enough for it to work. But if I mount it all at the back, then it's fine. The other thing is I've got nowhere really good for it to mount. So what I think I'm going to do is just, you know, at the front anyway, so I'm just going to have it on a magnet. And I'll just take it out and plug it in when I need to, when I'm cruising, basically. It'd be one of the things I add to the boat as opposed to take off. So, what I've got to work out now, this is where the horn's going to go. So this is my comedy horn, which I think kind of suits the boat, to be honest. It looks pretty cool. So, that is the comedy horn, and it's stuck on with a really heavy magnet. And I'm going to run a power source from there with a switch, so it'd be permanently live, flick the switch, and that'll sound the horn. I'll give it a go anyway. Right, so I've got my cigarette lighter there, which is quite useful because I can plug in many devices and use them on the outside. So then, obviously I need to tidy all this lot up, but I plug that in there when I'm going cruising. It's not particularly attractive because I've got a cable hanging around, although I could stow that away. I've got the, let's give it a go. I think it's quite loud, this comedy horn. Jesus, that is loud. Yeah, that is loud. Good. Well, at least it works. One thing I'd like to do is have a clear roof for the trip to London. I don't want much stuff in there. On top of the roof, but also I'd like to clean it as well. I'd like to give the boat a clean, give it a wash. But we're doing some more work. Rob's putting some undergunnel lights in the bow, and I'm going to clean my stern rail and repaint this because it's all chipped. That's because of the cover that goes on it. It just kind of rubs away, and I think I need to put one coat on it anyway. So I'm gonna key it up, so sand it back, put a key on it, and then put another coat of Manchester red. I was thinking whilst I'm here, I might as well paint that bit as well, get that, do it Manchester red. That'll work quite nicely. I would like to kind of clean this all up as well with the cream, but I've run out of cream. So if we get chance, just down there is Uxbridge Boat Centre, and they are stockists of Craftsmaster. So I might stock up whilst I'm passing. Yeah, we're going to see Wormwood Scrubs. So the plan's going to be, where are we? Right, the plan's going to be to get to Usley here, Uxbridge, Saturday kind of lunchtime if we can. That's the last lock, Cowley. And then this is all locked free to here to Paul's Bridge. Turn left, get through Northolt if we can, and then to here and overnight here in Horsenden Hill by the golf course. It's going to be a bit rural there. That should be okay. Near Perivale. What's that? 5.25 miles from Ballsbridge. That's not much. And then the next day, Sunday, basically go all the way through Park Royal. And then into through proper West London here. Kensal Town, West Kilburn. I might meet my cousin round here. She lives, I think, round here somewhere near, I don't know where it is. Then either, depending on the timing, go straight through Maida Hill Tunnel, through Regent's Park, spend a bit of time doing that, and then up into Camden there, and then overnight in Camden, turn around, come back, go to Paddington, maybe spend Sunday night in Paddington and larking around here, and then Monday back out and hightail it back to Northolt.
I really haven't chosen my time right, to be honest. It's pitch black, and this is the time I'm choosing to go about putting some more undergunnel lights in here so that when I get to London, this is all looking better and I want a bit of illumination under there. I've got undergunnel light. I got those lights here, which kind of illuminate this back wall, but I want some illumination under there.
I quite enjoy doing things like this, kind of in my own time, trying to make the cables nice and tidy. So got myself some cable ties and some of these things to kind of stick onto the bottom there. But it basically comes through the electrics cupboard, up through there. You see that shine light. Just got to clip, tidy up a little bit. Goes along there, then under the gunnels.
Right, so I've finished laying the cable now, and I've put an inline fuse in over there, and that's where the connection's going to be. So I'm just going to, what have I got to do? I've got to fire it up. So it's got its own dedicated switch, which I might change around at some point, but for the moment I'm going to leave it. Unplug that ridiculously bright light. You're not going to see much at the minute, but hopefully, once I plug this in, you'll see some light. Yes. Right, I don't like that setting, obviously, but it works. So I think I'm going to put one there, one there, one there, and one along there, just to illuminate that back bit and make it all fairly even. Right, cool. So this is the stern fully done now, in London mode. I think it looks great. There's obviously lights all the way around the front of the boat, but now the stern's nicely lit, and I reckon from an elevated position that's going to look pretty cool. So I can go onto my phone here and open up the app. Here it is. So I can change the colour and the whole lot changes. Go blue or green. I can't really get a white. That's the colour for white. Doesn't quite work. So I prefer an actual colour. Red's a bit kind of boudoir. Green, that's the preset for Bethnal green, which only really works when there's a little bit of light. But yeah, well chuffed with that.
Yeah, night, mate. We're so excited, Rob and I, about tomorrow. It's the big off tomorrow to go to London, and it's the second leg of our trip. So we're probably going to get to Ealing, which is Ealing Golf Club, really, which is nowhere near Ealing, to be honest. It's kind of Perivale way, but it's the only bit that looks remotely rural or quietish. We don't want to go as far as Alberton. I've seen that stretch. We do not want to spend a Friday night there. So, yeah.
we're kind of thinking Perivale might be the way forward, but we'll see how it goes. There's five locks to go, and then it's basically open canal with no locks, which would be brilliant. We've had one or two logistical changes. I've got no kids. Well, I do, but not here tonight or this weekend. So, which I'm a bit relieved about, to be honest, because it's all uncharted for me. It's going through central London on my narrowboat. I mean, as much as the kids would love it, I just want to kind of enjoy this for what it is with Rob and go to Camden and kind of not have the restrictions of having kids, to be honest. But equally, if they were to come, it would have been a brilliant experience for us all. But London's not a million miles away, despite how long it seems to take to get there on a bloody narrowboat. So I'll always better take them back there. But to do it the first time on my own with Rob will be great. We've kind of got the boats as ready as they can be. I've got fully supplied. I'm good to go. Leaving the car here, which will be cool, just going without a car. So for us continuous cruisers, kind of the bane of our life is moving a car all the time. So to actually go somewhere and come back to the car should be really cool. I'm picking up the kids, kind of the little girls, or they're being dropped off to me at some point during central London. So I don't know how that's going to work or if it will, but that'd be quite fun. But yeah, it's just going to be excellent. The boat's pretty much ready. I've got a few things to do in the morning whilst Rob is sorting out kids and stuff. So I've got to sort out my engine mounts and other bits and pieces. But I've checked my oil. That's pretty much all I've got to do on this. I've filled up with fuel. So yeah, it's all good to go. Just really can't wait. Rob and I have been kind of planning this for ages. So the fact that we're actually doing it is... Yeah, it's cool. So really glad you guys are here for the ride. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.